Dear friends, in Plumblege, France, where we live and practice, every time we hear the sound of the bell, we stop our thinking, we stop our talking, and we go back to our in-breath and breathe mindfully. And at least three times, in, out. And that practice is called listening to the bell, the sound, the bell of mindfulness. When you hear the bell, you naturally stop your thinking. It has become a habit. You naturally stop your thinking and you focus your attention on your in-breath and you enjoy breathing in. And when you breathe in mindfully like that, you bring your mind home to your body and you become fully alive in the here and the now. It takes only 3 seconds in order to bring the mind home to the body and establish ourselves in the here and the now. And when you are well established in the here and the now, you can get in touch with life. First of all, your body, your feelings, your perceptions, your mental formations, your consciousness. And you get in touch with the wonders of life around you. The energy of mindfulness has the power to heal, to transform. In the Buddhist tradition, when you begin to breathe in mindfully, you bring your mind home to your body. And when mind and body are together, you are truly there. In our daily life, very often our body is there, but our mind is not there. We are not truly there. It's impossible to love if you are not there. So practice mindful breathing. Bring your mind home to your body. It can help you to be there. Our in-breath, our out-breath is something like a bridge linking mind and body. And the moment when we pay attention to our in-breath and breathe in mindfully, we bring our mind home to our body and we are there in just 2 or 3 seconds. And you can look, you can go to your beloved one, looking in your, in his eyes or her eyes, and you can say, "Darling, I'm here for you. Your presence is the most precious gift that you can make to your beloved one." It's very easy. Everyone can do that. To me, to love means to be there for your beloved one. And to be there for me is not a willing, an intention, a desire. That is a practice. In order to be there, you need to breathe in mindfully and bring your mind home to your body. Or you might like to practice walking meditation, mindful walking. While breathing in, you make 1 step or 2 steps. And you become aware of the step you make. You are touching life in the present moment with your foot. One step alone can bring you home to the here and the now and be fully present in the here and the now. There are many ways of practice that can help bring our mind home to our body so that we can be established in the here and the now. And then you practice, when you practice breathing in, I'm aware of my body. This is the third exercise recommended by the Buddha in the Sutra on Mindful Breathing. Breathing in, I'm aware of my body. Mindfulness of the body. You know that your body is there. And while breathing in like that, you bring your mind home to your body. And there you are, alive, present. And you might discover that your body also belongs to the kingdom of God. Your body, like that flower, is a wonder. And you can touch the kingdom of God also in your body. You don't have to go far. And in the future, in order to get in touch with the kingdom of God. Mindfulness allowed us to be alive and to touch the wonders of life inside of us and around us. And many of these wonders have the power to heal, to nourish. And you don't have to go to a temple in order to practice mindfulness. Walking from the parking lot to your office, you might enjoy the practice of mindful walking. You might like to enjoy every step. Touching the wonders of life, that is something all of us can do. So from the parking lot to your office, you may like to do like that. You stop all your thinking and you enjoy every step. Walk in such a way that every step can bring you freedom. Can bring you solidity, freedom, and healing. Many of us use the practice of mindful walking to heal ourselves. When you breathe in mindfully and focus your attention on your breath, when you make a step mindfully and focus your attention on your step, you release the past, you release the future, you release all your projects. Because your mind has only one object, that is your in-breath and your, or your step. One in-breath or one step can set you free. Free from the worries and the uncertainty about future. Worry, free from the regret and the sorrow concerning the past. The past may be a prison, the future may be a prison. If you are subjected to regret, sorrow, fear, uncertainty, but when you focus your attention on your in-breath, you release everything. So one breath, one in-breath set you free. One step making mindfulness set you free. And when you are free, your body has regained its power to heal itself. And your mind also.